Today's liturgy puts together a beautiful reading from the prophet Ezekiel, who talks about the vision that he had of this water flowing from the temple, that it started as a trickle at the entrance, gradually turned into a stream and then a river that could not even be crossed. And it's clear that in both Old and New Testament, water becomes a symbol of life, of God's presence, and of God's graciousness. And we see that reach its ultimate conclusion, obviously, in the waters of baptism. That Jesus himself goes into the waters of the baptism of repentance that John the Baptist was proclaiming and acting, even though he, as the sinless one, identifies with our sin. And so his baptism becomes a foreshadowing of the cross. So this beautiful image of this immense flow of water, this immense flow of God's grace given to us. It's coupled with the gospel from John chapter 5, where this man who is ill is lying at the pool of Bethesda and waiting for somebody to lower him into the water. So the tradition was that an angel would come down and stir the water, so the first person that entered the water would be healed. And so Jesus heals the man on the spot. He'd been ill for 38 years, paralyzed, crippled. And Jesus asks him an interesting question. Do you want to be well? That seems like such a self-evident thing, that this man was there. Obviously, he wanted to be well. But it indicates that Jesus is very curious to know the desire, the intention, the willingness of the person that he is about to heal. And we see that in its opposite effect, where in Nazareth, the Gospels narrate that he was not able to perform any miracles there because of their lack of faith. So it isn't that Jesus just shows up and does these miraculous healings and offers these graces with or without the will of the person receiving them. The person's receptivity is very important to Jesus. So he will only act in our life if we're open to it, if we desire it, if we want it. To me, that says that our faith then is really an exercise of desire, to grow in our desire for God, to want Jesus to live within us, to act within us, and to give us the graces that we need. So there's something very laudable about going to the Lord and asking. You know, sometimes we hesitate to do that, thinking, you know, I'm not worthy, or my prayer won't be heard. But the Lord wants us to ask. And he wants us to ask with boldness and confidence, knowing that our desire and our receptivity is important to him in terms of how he acts. So the more free we are, the more faith-filled we are, the more freedom he has to act within us. So we go to the Lord with that boldness. Yes, Lord, we want to be well. Yes, Lord, we want to be forgiven. Yes, Lord, we want to be healed.